Internet gizentzen ari da. Geroz eta pisu handiagoa du, datu trafikoari dagokionez. Ikertzaile batzuk egindako aurreikuspenek diote trafiko hori bi zetabaitekoa izango dela 2019an. Asko da? Dexente. Bi bilioi giga datu da hori. 1984-tik 2013 bitartean interneten mugitu zen datu kopuru berdina urte bakarrean. Konektatutako gailuak 14.000 milioitik 24.000 milioira igoko dira 3 urte barru. Mugikorrak, tabletak, telebistak eta autoak, frigorifikoak, gauza ia guztien internet izango da. Eta ara eta ona dabilen informazioak geroz eta pisu handiagoa izango du. Pentsa, gaur egun internet bidez bideo zerbitzua eskaintzen duen enpresa bakar batek Estatu Batuetako trafikoaren herena mugitzen du. Eta zabaltzen ari dira gainera antzeko zerbitzuak. 3G, 4G eta laster 5G sareak. Wifiaren ondoren Lifia etorriko da. Bereizmen handiko filme bat 10 segundoan deskargatzeko gaitasuna emango digun sare optikoa. Aurrerapen teknologiko guztiak banda zabalera handitzera zuzenduta daude. Guztiak? Ez? Basic Internet Fundazioan oinarrizko edukiak zabaldu nahi dituzte gaitasun txikiko sareetatik. Helburua, haustura digitala gainditu eta informazioa denon esku jartzea.
Proiektua berez hasi zen Noruegan, Scheller izeneko herri txiki batean. Eta, bueno, garai hartan joan zen Gik Amanda izeneko pertsona bat, berez Kongokoa dena. Esanez edo eskatuz interneta Kongora eramateko.
And he said, you know, there is no internet out there. And then we tried with conventional internet and we saw that simply the affordability, the price of that internet was too expensive. Can you imagine, it costed like $420 per month to get a very, very bad internet connection. And then we thought, what kind of technologies can we apply to make content very, very cheap and to bring information out for people for free?
Gero 2014-eko abenduan, baia proiektu hau edo Basic Internet Fundazio bezala sortu zen.
The aims of the Basic Internet Foundation is basically to bring the basic access to everyone out in the world. And from basic access we talk about information, which we define as text and pictures. Because we think that everyone in the world should have the ability to get free text and pictures information out.
Internetak gaur egun ematen diguna da informazioa. Eta informazio hori beharrezkoa da bai hezkuntzarako, baita osasunerako eta enpresak bultzatzeko, ezta? Informazioa oinarrizko baliabide bada. Horregatik da interneta beharrezkoa mundu guztiarentzat.
Our starting point is again that we would like to make it cheap. So we buy very cheap small boxes which only costs you like $40. And with these cheap boxes, we tell the people, put them up and then make whatever connection to the internet you find. We basically connect to a remote server in Norway, which then filters out everything which is not information. So at the end of the day, we have a content filtering which says, well, if you want to have video, you have to pay for it, for the video is so expensive. Like the example which we have is, you can either give a person in Africa 10 months of information, or you can give him 7 minutes of video. It's the same price, it's the same costs.
Adibidez, bideo bat erreproduzitzea nahi balin badugu, hor behar dugun bandwidth edo sarek, kapazitate maila oso altua da, ez? Horrek egiten duena da murriztu interneta zenbat jendei heltze zaion. Hau da, nahi balin badezu gero eta jende gehiago eduki sarera konektatuta, orduan hobeto dira kapazitate limitatua daukaten sariak.
so they can just like click themselves, and lots of them, they don't even understand the number. So you ask them, what does 4.6 mean? And they have no idea. So you need to tell them in green or red that this value is okay and that value is not okay. Type of personalized digital information. And what we found out is that hospitals don't even have this easy access network. So we asked Mondragon University, we asked Iñaki to develop a specific solution for this hospital so that the women can download the app, can get all the information about pregnancy and diabetes, and would have a better life because they adopted.
Ni sartu nintzen baita proiektuan, eta ba, gero Arrasateko Unibertsitatea, Mondragon Unibertsitatea, bilakatu zen Basic Interneteko partner teknologiko bezala.
I would say in Norway we are too few people, right? We only have like 5 million people, and we are not that good at technology. When it comes to technology, you have much better people down here at Mondragon. So when Iñaki, at the end of the day, went back, we asked for this collaboration. We then say, let the technical headquarter be here in Mondragon and let us develop all the technology which we need in all the world here in Mondragon so that we can apply it in Congo and in everywhere else. And of course, that means that if there is a request coming from Kinshasa for a server which needs to be connected, then that request is going to Iñaki.
Bueno, ba, esan nahi du, teknologiarekin zerikusia duten gauza guztietan bermaten duela laguntza, ez? Sareak definitzen dituela edo diseinatzen dituela eta horrez gain ba, laguntzen duela maila teknologikoa edo zen egun erronka teknologikoarekin zerikusia daukaten gauza guztiak aurrera eramaten. Diseinua, implementazioa, konfigurazioa, gauza guzti horiek.
I'm very happy with the collaboration which I have here because I see that the education and the value of education which the students get here is really, really good. And that is the starting point, like having a good technology and then combining it with, let me say, the Norwegian attitude of running around in the world and making connections, which together is a very, very good partnership where we invite others to simply join us.